count method.
Right, so here in this method, each and every record, maintain one special element, that is counter. So counter represents the how many times the record is to be searched, right? So counter represents the how many number of times the record is to be searched, right? So the most frequently, so for suppose which record contains greater count value, that records are placed at first position, right? First position of the file. So greater count records are placed at first position of the file, right? So here this is about count method. So in this method, each and every record maintains one element, that element is called as counter. So counter represents the how many number of times a record is to be searched, right? So first suppose R1 record contains 50 times, R3 record contains 30 times. So for each and every we are maintaining one counter element, right? So for suppose here I am taking one example for counter method. So here I am taking our input file is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. So in counter method, each and every record maintains one element, that is called as counter. For suppose I am already searching R1 is 100 times, R2 is 90 times, R3 is 40 times, R4 is 40 times. For each and every searching, the counter value is incremented by 1. For suppose here I want to search R3 record. So after completion of that search, R3 counter is incremented by 1. So that is 41, right? So R5 is 20. So this is our file information. So in this file, I want to search R4 record. So in sequential search, we are applying searching process in sequential manner until we can find out the desired record in the file, right? So first of all, R1 we are not found, then R2, R3, R4. So R4 is found. So after find out element, so counter value is incremented by 1. Now counter value becomes 41. So when compared to 40, 41 is greater value. So that's why R4 is placed at this position, right? So in counter method, so here most frequently elements are placed at first position. So simply greater count value, the records are placed at first positions, right? So here when compared to R3 count, R4 count is greater. So that's why we are placing R4 at this position and R3 is placed at this position, right? So now output file becomes R1, R2, R3, R5, 20, right? So this is about the count method, right? So these are the three methods to improvise the performance of sequential search, right? So these methods that are comes under self-organized sequential
such.
Self-organized sequential
such,
right? So this is about improvised for linear search process or sequential search process, right? So coming to what are the advantages of sequential file organization? Advantages of sequential file organization. In olden days, sequential files are stored in tapes or disks. Tapes or
disks. Sequential files. Sequential file organization.
So, first advantage is very simple and
easy method.
So, very simple and most commonly used method.
Right? So, very simple and most commonly used method. In olden days, we are also using sequential file organization. Commonly used method.
Oh, second advantage. So very efficient file organization technique. In which cases? When most of the records must be processed, then only we can say that this is very efficient method, right?
A very efficient method. Efficient method when most of the records must be processed.
Must be processed. So this is the advantage. So for suppose we are processing all the records, then only we can say that this is very efficient method, right? So coming to drawbacks.
So drawbacks are disadvantages.
So for suppose if I want to search a single record, to search all the records sequentially, it takes more time, right?
So processing time is more,
right?
So entire file must be processed.
So here process is nothing but searching, right?
So entire file must be processed to search even a single record in the file. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of sequential file organization, right? So coming to what are the real time examples for sequential file organization?
Oh, here there are several real time examples for sequential file organization. For suppose I am considering student attendance file.
So student attendance file contains student number, student name, student department, student attendance. Well, suppose also Phi01, Phi02, Phi03, Phi04. So A, B, C, A. CSE.
So in previous month attendance is, for suppose I am considering 80%, 70%, 75%, 90%, right? So after completion of each and every month, teacher wants to update the student attendance. For that purpose, teacher sequentially process the records in the file, right? So for suppose after completion of next month, so teacher wants to update the
attendance status, right? So here one by one. So here 501 is updated 90. So 90, 95, 100. So here these are the updated attendance. For updation purpose, teacher search sequentially. Teacher search sequentially. Right? So this is the best example for sequential file organization. But suppose I am considering one more file, that is employee salary status file organization. So employee salary status file. Salary status. So in that file, employee number, employee name, employee department, salary status. Paid or not status, right? So for suppose 501, 502, 503, 504, A, B, C, A. So department CSC, 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 CSC. So here, for suppose in previous month, salary is paid. Now after completion of month, so the salaries are already paid, right? Now check, now update the status of each and every person in the file. So in such cases, compulsory we are sequentially process the all records in the file, right? So here, so after completion of 1 month, so 501 salary is paid, so status is updated. For suppose 502, 503 salaries are not paid, so simply here status is not paid for this month, not paid. So here for salary status updation, organization process the records sequentially, that is one by one, right? So these are the simple examples for sequential file organizations, right? So this is about sequential file organization. So in next sessions, we are discussing about what is direct file organization and what is indexed sequential file organization, right? So if you have any doubts regarding to this session, please post your doubts in comment section. Thank you.